Thank you, Philip, and thank you very much for the invitation to the organizers. They have done, Monica and Christoph, they have done an incredible job. I am enjoying very much this conference. I'm sorry that we cannot meet. We meet virtually this time, but that we can meet personally in the future. Well, the title of my talk, it is Exponentially Correlated Hilliard Configuration Interaction Method, the singlet ground state of the helium atom. And this work has been done in collaboration with Jim Sims from the National Institute of Standard and Technology from the in USA, and Bolanath Paddy from the Calicut College in Odisha State, India. I will pass to the outline of this talk. First, I will talk about the importance of the cusps in the wave function, and I will show some CI calculations of the helium atom. I'm sorry for this line, I don't know how to put it up. And then I will make a review of the explicit correlated wave functions. The second point will be to explain why the exponential Hilliard CI wave function. Then we will pass to the methodology, where I will define the wave function and I will speak about the calculation of the integrals. And finally, I will show some calculations. Okay, important of the cups in the wave function, this is well known. You see here the cups condition, the electronic, and this suggests this equation that the wave function should be include inter-electronic coordinate in linear form or in exponential form or both. The inter-electronic coordinate represents the situation when the two electrons get close to zero, and it is at the instance you can see here in the Cartesian coordinates. Wave functions which contains Rij in linear form, this means odd power, converge very rapidly to the SAT solution. Why? Because this mathematically, this odd power can be expressed as an infinite expansion of excitation to other angular orbitals. But the even powers, they are only just one excitation. These are the ones that are in the CI wave function, configuration interaction. And this is the reason why the configuration interaction converges slowly to the exact solution. This we saw in these calculations of the helium atom. These were made by Sims and Hanson in the year 2002. And you can see here about 5,000 configurations, and they have been used orbitals up to U type. And you see that the energy converts very slowly. We have here only 5 digits accuracy, so less than microhartree. It means that the shortcomings of the CI wave function and other ab initio methods like coupled cluster, multi-configurational, Hartree-Fock, and so on, is the slow convergence. And this means that we need a very, very large, as well known, number of Slater determinants. Why the Hilliard CI, exponential Hilliard CI? Eventually, at some very high regions, accuracy regions of the Hilliard CI wave function, this means after the G or the E orbitals or 20 digits accuracy, one sees a slowdown in the convergence. The second reason is in the 60s, Hirschfelder has already proposed an exponential factor, and this factor describes well the cusp and also the decay of the wave function of the inter-electronic distance for large when it goes to infinity. Finally, it will be possible in this way to extend the exponential correlated Slater method to larger systems with more than 3 electrons. And we are interested in highly accurate calculations with moderate computational effort. I show here this slowdown in calculations in the Hilliard CI calculations of helium atom. They were done by Sims and Hanson in the year 2002. And they are very accurate. We have here about 18 decimal digits, but we see here in this region by gay and e orbitals a slow convergence. And this is maybe due, this can be expected in other atoms like beryllium that happened the same. And this may be due to a missing double cusp. This means terms containing R12, R34 at the same time. Let us define the exponential Hilaire CI wave function. This wave function contains this term. This term has both the interelectronic distance in linear form and in exponential form. If the power is nu is equal to zero, then this will lead to the exponential correlated Slater wave function. If the power, if the nonlinear parameter is zero, then we will have the Hilaire CI term. And if the both are zero, then we will have the CI wave function. So this is the wave function is a linear combination of configurations. These configurations are poor states of spin and angular momentum. They contain this correlation term and a Hartree product, and all of them are antisymmetrized. Let me go back because I think that I have missed because the mouse, I have missed one here. Sorry, this is an important slide. This was the comparison and I am speaking here of all explicitly correlated wave functions. The R12 wave function contains only the R12 interelectronic coordinate and it gets chemical accuracy. This means less than a millihartree. The F12 is an extension in exponential form. The CI wave function doesn't contain the interelectronic coordinate and the best calculations, they are less than microhartree in helium and they are about millihartree accuracy in larger atoms. Then we have the exponential correlated Gaussian, especially here in Poland by Jacek Komasa. The interelectronic coordinate contains all interelectronic distance to the power 2 Gaussian in Gaussian form. And this wave function is very accurate, has been applied, has no limit of application, can be applied to any atom or molecule, and has the disadvantage that it doesn't fulfill the CAPS condition, and then one has to optimize many nonlinear parameters. The Hilaire wave function, it contains all interelectronic coordinates at the same time. Therefore, it's restricted to three electron systems, right? Because otherwise one will have integrals which have not been still solved. The accuracy, as you see, is very, very high. Yesterday, we have in the talk of Timon Killig, he talked about the possibility to use this Hilaire wave function with the restriction of only one interelectronic coordinate per term to any power. I have told essentially this will be the same that will be the Hilaire CI wave function is only a difference in the form. In the form here we will have interelectronic coordinates to any power and in the Hilaire wave function Hilaire CI wave function, we have excitations, configurations, a la CI. So I have told this, that in the Hilaire CI, we have only one interelectronic coordinate to the power one, and not only the ground configuration, we have excitation to other angular momentum orbitals. Then it comes the exponential Hilaire CI wave function. We will see the accuracy that achieved. The afterwards come the exponential correlated Slater, they are very, very accurate. The interelectronic coordinates come only in the exponent to the power one. In the last time, it is used also with linear terms and is extremely accurate. This accuracy we want to use. And finally, we have here the iterative complement iteration wave function. This can be understood as an analytical wave function. It's a wave function that contains not only linear terms and exponential, also logarithmic terms, negative powers, fractionary powers. And this wave function gives an accuracy of 40 decimal digits, and it can be applied only to two electron system. You can see here, it is very impressive, the energy of helium atom calculated by Nakashima Nakatsuchi in 2007, also by Schwartz. Okay, I have defined the Hiller CI wave function, and we saw here first calculations that we have repeated from the literature. The black one, this is exponential wave function from Sine and Pack from the year 68. We have repeated this calculation. Here in green, we have a Hilleras wave function also from Sine and Pack, and other wave function that can be considered the first exponential Hilleras wave function from Bonan and Cole. It contains linear terms, exponential, and both at the same time. Well, we have repeated these calculations. One has to say that the exponents, they were extremely very optimized, and it was difficult to improve these energies, but we have added more terms, and we have seen that such a wave function lead to better results. Well, the methodology. So we get, with such a wave function, we get these integrals. Here are the Slater orbitals, the correlation terms, and with prime, they are the orbitals on the right-hand side. The first is to do angular integration, and I would like to mention that we like to use the Condon and Sortley coefficients, as you see here. And this IL, this is a radial integral of this form. Depending on L, that is the angular momentum. And this integral can be expressed, as we will see, in terms of the so-called gamma integral that is used very much by Harris and others. Well, then we have several methods, three methods we have used to solve these radial integrals. The first one we have used only for testing purposes was developed by Nakasuchi and co-workers. It consists on the integration, direct integration over the inter-electronic coordinate. We get an expression that unfortunately contains minus signs, and in the praxis for high L, one loses from 8 to 10 decimal digits from 30. So this is not appropriate for highly accurate calculations. In addition, we can get in several cases, for example, in the evaluation of four electron integrals or kinetic energy integrals, we will get negative integrals, which are solvable, but this is difficult. Anyway, to get accuracy, one has only to go to higher precision, and then one gets the correct results. The second method, this is to express the integrals in terms of this kinetic gamma function. This gamma function or integral is a basic one defined from the times of Sack, Rutan, and Kolos. Harris used that very much. So the radial integrals can be expressed as a linear combination of gamma functions. This method we have used also for checking purposes. And the third method is our L equals zero integral. This is just this gamma function. And there are known from the literature from the 60s, these functions with the zero indices, negative and a symmetry property, and it is possible to construct the gamma function using recursion relations. This is the method that is more stable, and this is the one that has been used. Well, we have to calculate also the kinetic energy integrals. As in the Hilleras CI method, we like to use the Colon and Rutan transformation. This has been achieved by one of our authors, by Paddy, and is very tricky because one is using the properties of the Laplace and Nabla operator and the turnover rule, but then it is possible to express the kinetic energy integral as such a easy usual kinetic energy integrals in the CI method. The same we have tried for when there are powers, nu and prime equal one, and I'm still working on that. But one can get one the expression, the correct expression, making the differentiation with respect to omega and omega prime. This has done by Paddy, and we obtain this looks complicated, but it is just a linear combination of integrals of this type, a usual repulsion overlap integrals. Well, and here we have the first calculations using this method. And this, we do it, what it is called here, the so-called energy limits. So for S orbitals, L equals zero, the best energy that you can get. For L equal one, it means SP orbitals, the best energy, and so on up to F orbitals. Well, first, we took the calculations from me, and then it was this basis, this was simply double, adding the same configurations, but multiplied by the exponential factor. And then we see here, improve of the convergence, the energy very much improved, so that we can compare with the next limit and even with the following limit. So it has been a very strong improve in the convergence. So we have a surpass in the energy limits of one or two steps. Okay, the same has been done using more accurate calculations using the so-called double basis set. In the double basis set means they are Hilbert-CI wave function with one exponent, the outer exponent, and adding the same one with other exponent that is representing the inner correlation. This is an idea originally from Drake. So these are the first the calculations, energy limits calculated by Simpson Hastron in 2002. And we have here the energy results. So, and these, they have been simply doubled, adding the same configuration with the exponential factor. And then we see the same surpass of energy, the convergence is strongly accelerated. I would like to mention here from these calculations that with orbital 6, also mean E orbitals, okay, it is a 10,000 configuration, we have got the best energy that is 21 digits accurate. The comparison is with the Hilbert-CI method, one gets also a very good energy, but note you have to realize that here the orbitals are high angular momentum. We compare always with the calculations of Nakazuchi group, which can be and Schwarz, that they can be considered exact. Of course, we have optimized also the nonlinear parameter and obtained at the improvement of the energy. We have got one digit more. So here are the calculations, our best calculation, 21 decimal digits accuracy. And we compare here with the calculation of Korobov, which I will comment now. So this is the comparison, the best energies of the synchrotron state of Helium atom. First of all, we have the famous calculation from Frankowski and Pekeris, which was very accurate. This calculation was improved by Freund, Hus, Table, and Morgan. Then we should compare also with the very accurate calculation of Takar and Kova using the exponential correlated Slater method. Afterwards come the calculation from Jan and Drake using the Hilbert method. This calculation was improved later with more configurations. Very important is also the calculation for Goldman, very accurate, and the calculations from Korobov, they are exponential correlated Slater. Means the inter-electronic coordinates, they are only in the exponent, and he used random nonlinear parameters which were very exhaustively optimized for different regions of the structure. This is very, very exhaustive optimization, which you can see here. We prefer to keep the orbital picture and not to do simply a mathematical method. So here we have the Hilera CI best result, which has been obtained recently, and the best exponential Hilera CI results. They count between the more accurate calculations nowadays. Here you can see the calculation of Schwarz used 24,000 configurations to get such accuracy. Well, I am almost done. The conclusions are the following. The exponential correlation factor is one of the more effective correlation factors. Introduced at most one per configuration, then this method can be used to atomic systems with more than four electrons, with four or more electrons. This gives us the possibility to calculate beryllium atom beyond the nanohertz accuracy and possibly to overcome this double cusp missing term, this R12, R34 term, and to make calculations of boron and other atoms with more accuracy. Well, I hope that you have got interested in this method, and I would like to dedicate this talk to the memory of our great teacher and friend, the Professor Stanley Hanstrom. He is the inspiration behind Hilera CI, the founder of the method, together with James Sims. He was also a student of Sewell, had to be also with Lodin, and had a lot of students with him in Indiana University. He was very enthusiastic and would have liked to see these results that he was also proposing to do. And well, I am done, and thank you very much for your attention.
Thanks very much, Belén. Excellent timekeeping. In fact, we're slightly ahead of schedule, so there's plenty of time for questions if there are any. Please either speak up or put them on the chat. In the meantime, I have a question myself, which is when you are dealing with the helium atom, you're dealing with a pair of electrons, just one pair. So there is just one Rij to expand. Can you briefly say how much more complicated it would be for an atomic system with more than two electrons, like three, four?
Yes, in the case of three electrons, then one will have to solve the so-called triangle integral, integral with three electrons, three inter-electronic coordinates at the same time. Maybe you have heard about this integral from Fromm and Hill. And then there is a big step to solve this integral, which is infinite. One needs an acceleration, convergence acceleration. This is one. The other integrals are solved for larger systems. It will be no problem. And there is a computational cost. Yeah, when the system is larger, then you have to calculate always up to four electron integrals, but combined with other overlaps and so on. I cannot say, but the calculations in Helium are very, very fast. This is a question of seconds or minutes. The calculations of in larger atoms, it will be much longer, but they are possible. It's only a question of computer knowledge, also algorithms, question of money, if you have people working on this and they develop programs, but the principal ideas and concepts, except the triangle integral, are solved.
Well, it's very nice to see the Hilera-CI approach still being used, because we're slowly but surely approaching the centenary. Can you comment Nakatsuji's ICI approach? Because you say that it is analytic, but in fact it is iterative. They have a function which they improve by iteration with some stronger conditions on the square of expectation values and so on.
Well, I have called it analytically because in the past, such a wave functions that contains all the necessary terms that they are not known that contribute to the energy, they were called analytical wave functions, and they are at once, not iterative. And Nakatsuji and co-workers, they include every correlation term in an iterative way. So they do like a linear combination of configuration, and the same that Schwartz. And this, of course, is the best wave function, but because it contains logarithmic terms, the three electron integrals, as far as I know, they have not been solved for logarithms.
There's a question on the chat, which I will read to you. It's from Timon Kilic. Why does the convergence of the Hylaras CI for helium slow down with large angular momentum values, even though there is no double cusp in helium?
Mm-hmm. Well, this is a good question. Well, this, I don't know how to say. Maybe Jim Sims can answer. Maybe they are missing these logarithmic terms, that this is other cap, other kind of coalescence with the nucleus or so. So the Rij, this is not the only term that should be in the wave function. As we have seen from Nakatsuji, they are missing terms. Negative terms, fractionary, logarithmic, and so on.
Well, just to finish, do you have a physical interpretation of these logarithmic terms? Because obviously, if you're just looking at Rij, there's no need to have a logarithm.
Yes, the physical interpretation is two electrons interaction with the nucleus at the same time. You have to think in the logarithms curve.
Okay. Well, let's thank Belen.
Thank you.
And